Welcome, AEON Study Circle. Today, for current affairs, 31st March 2020. The importance of 31st March. Prartha Samaj was established by Renard Bandhekar and others at Mumbai in 1864. Prarthana Samaj or Prayer Society in Sanskrit was the movement for religious and social reform in Bombay. Based on earlier reform movement, Prarthana Samaj was founded by Atmaran Pandurang in 1869 when Keshav Chandrasen visited Maharashtra with an aim to make people believe in a one God or worship only one God. B.P. Gaurang was reappointed as the Deputy Governor of RBI. B.P. Gaurang was reappointed as the Deputy Governor of Reserve Bank of India. The appointed Committee of Cabinet, ACC, approved the extension of Kanoj's term as RBI Deputy Governor by 1 year. It will be effective from 3rd April when his 3 year tenure comes to an end. P.P. Kanurag served as an executive director of the RBI in April 2017. He was elevated to the post of deputy governor. He is in charge of department like currency management, payment and settlement, foreign exchange, internal debit management, among others. Kanurag is a career central banker. He joined the RBI in September 1982. He has worked in several functional areas of bank such as foreign exchange management, banking and non-banking supervisor, currency management, government and bank accounts, and public debit. Next, Central launched standard in India to help foreign tourists. The Ministry of Tourism has launched a portal, Standard in India. The portal aimed to help foreign tourists who are stuck in various parts of India. Standard in India. The aim of the portal is extend support to foreign tourists who are stranded in India. The Ministry of Tourism launched the portal to disseminate information regarding the service that can be availed by foreign tourists who are stuck far away from their homeland. People can visit the standardinindia.com. The portal consists of information around COVID-19 helpline numbers and all centers that foreign tourists can reach out for help from Ministry of External Affairs control centers. Next, Diyatra launched virtual assistant to curb fake message on coronavirus. Dinyatra to pioneers in Indian language NLP and conversational AI has launched ARM, a virtual assistant to chatbot, was developed to provide answers to the concern of the COVID-19 crisis. ARM is released in 7 languages, namely Marathi, Malayalam, Kannada, Telugu, Hindi and Tamil, in addition to English. ARM aims to combat the rise of fake news related to COVID-19 containing across India and the world. ARM will provide factual information caused by the World Health Organization and the Minister of Health and Family Welfare. Users can now visit and converse with ARM or www.arm.ai. and on Facebook Messenger. Arm provide information about COVID-19 and the precaution one should take not to contract or contribute to the container. The board will help people to perform self-diagnosis to identify their risk profile. A user can also get the statistics of the worldwide spread of the contingent emergency number to the contact information about COVID-19 diagnostic and treatment centers designated by the government, etc. The chatbot is built over the conversation AI platform, the.ai. Users can either speak to ARM using a microphone or type into their inquiries in their language of choice. Next, China recommended beer while to treat COVID-19 patient. The National Health Commission of China published a list of recommended treatment to treat COVID-19 apart from Western medical and Chinese medicine. In the list include Tandiquin injection that contain beer bile powder. Beer bile powder. Tandiquin is secreted by the liver and stored in the gallbladder of the beer. The bile from various species of beers, including Asiatic black beers and brown beers, has been used as a traditional Chinese medicine since the 18th century. Beer bile contains a high level of urodeoxychloric acid, also known as a urosildol. It has been clinically proven to help dissolve gallstone and treat liver diseases. Urosildichloric acid has been available as a synthetic drug worldwide for decades. The process of extracting bile from the liver bile is painful and can cause agony to the animal. Hence, a synthetic version of urodeoxychloride has been available for decades. Next, Government of India extend validity of expired driving license and vehicle registration till 13th June. The Ministry of Road Transport and Highways have announced an extension on the validity of documents like driving license, permit and registration that are expired since 1st February. The Ministry has directed all state and union territories to treat the document as valid till 13th June 2020. Highlight, the move to the government aim to help the people who face difficulties in renewing the validity of various motor vehicle documents due to the nationwide lockdown and closure the government transport offices due to the coronavirus outbreak. As per the ministry guideline, the document include fitness permit of all types, driving license, registration or any other concerned document under motor vehicle rules. The ministry has directed all state union territories to implement so that the people and transporters and organizations that render essential service do not get harassed and face difficulties amid the lockdown aimed to curb the spread of COVID-19. The Ministry of Road and Transport Highways, formed on July 1942, headquarters New Delhi, Minister Responsible Nitin Gadkari, Deputy Minister Responsible General returned V.K. Singh, the Ministry Responsible Development and Maintenance of National Highways of the country. Next topic is Nagma launch virtual tour of its permanent collection. National Gallery of Modern Art Nagma celebrated the 66th Foundation Day on 29th March 2020. On the occasion, Nagma launched virtual tour of permanent collection for the visitors. Virtual tour by Nagma. People are not allowed to visit Nagma due to the lockdown for 21 days. in India as a measure to curb COVID-19 spread. The virtual launch was launched so that the visitors can enjoy without having a physical visit to museum. It has plenty to explore and ponder over. The permanent collection reflected to Respiratory as an institution of dynamic and progressive collective acumen. The sculptures, painting, and prints in visual tour are a step further to showcase the hidden treasure of the restored collection. The visual tour was a tribute to modern masters. It was expected that it will generate greater interest among people towards the legacy of sculptures, painting, and prints as the creative medium. The website for the virtual art tour is http://www.ngmaindia.gov.in/index.asp. National Gallery of Modern Art, NAGMA. NAGMA was established on 29th March 1954. It is located in New Delhi. The premier art gallery is one of the world's largest modern art museum. It functions under the Ministry of Culture, Government of India. NAGMA has subsequent branches at Mumbai and Bangalore. Thank you. Think before you speak, read before you think. Prepared by J. Kutanes, Aeon Study Circle. If you join our study group or social media, Facebook, Aeon Study Circle, WhatsApp, 0984602-4053, Telegram, Aeon Study Circle.